Hey, Travis. Trevor Gross from CUTigers.com here. I know that y'all prepare every week the same and play to your own standard, regardless of the opponent. But it's not often that you have such a marquee matchup with a top 10 team during the regular season. Does that just add a little bit of excitement for you guys?
Yeah, I think naturally that definitely does. Like you said, I mean, the whole philosophy of our program is just this is the biggest game of the year because it's the next one, and that's how we treat every game. But I mean, there's definitely some extra excitement and sense of urgency because we're playing at home, game day, at night in the Valley against a really good team in Miami that's top 10. So definitely really excited, and you don't get, like you said, you don't get a lot of opportunities like that. So I think it's really important to play well, like it is every week, but even more so this week. So we're definitely excited to get the chance to prepare and to have a good week leading up to it.
Hey, Trevor. David Hood. When you watch Miami play, at least when you watch them on TV, CBN, they talk before the play, they talk during the play, they talk junk and smack after the play. They're out there having fun. Do you enjoy those type of games where, you know, there's just something going on constantly out there, but you know, between the two teams?
Yeah, I mean, that's fun. I mean, it's that's like when you have matchups like that, it's just a lot of fun to be a part of. It's really competitive every play, kind of going back and forth, and that's exciting for sure. I think that's just part of what they do, and that's part of how they operate. I think one way to try to, whether that's getting people's heads or just kind of hypes themselves up, you know, definitely is part of the game plan, I think. So, but yeah, it's going to be a lot of fun. Those games are always fun to be a part of.
Trevor, this is Larry Williams with TigerIllustrated.com. Are they a good bit less exotic than Virginia was in terms of they just sort of line up and feel like they're better than you and not doing a whole lot of a bunch of funky stuff defensively?
Yeah, I mean, I watched some yesterday, but haven't really gotten, you know, too in depth with, you know, necessarily their structure and different things they bring on third down, all those things yet. We'll definitely hit some of that today and going forward. But from just what I see, I think you're right. They do what they do, and they do it well. You know, it's not necessarily that they're trying to confuse you. They want to make sure that they're in the right spot, and they've shown they have the playmakers to be successful that way. So they do a good job of being where they're supposed to be, making plays, relying on their speed to handle guys. A lot of, like, they give you like kind of a lot of one-on-one because they really trust their guys. But obviously they got a lot of athletes on the D-line, linebackers, and in the secondary. So a lot of speed, definitely, which is good to have as a defense for sure. So I would think you're probably right as far as structurally they don't change as much as Virginia. Virginia did a really good job of switching it up, and you know, it's kind of hard to tell sometimes what they were in. But I think Miami is they do what they do, and they do it well.
Trevor, this is Dennis Dodd from CBS Sports. Growing up, what do you remember about Miami?
I just know historically Miami's always been a powerhouse. They've just always had a certain swag about them that when you play them, you know what you're going to get. And I think they're definitely getting back to that, and that's really good to see. But that's probably all I can really remember.
Yeah. Let's just speak about their defense particularly. They seem to be better just athletically. They got some dudes over there.
Yeah, I think they're just figuring out how to put it all together. I think obviously they've had some coaching changes in the years past, and I think they're finally getting into a place where they're putting it together. They're figuring out how to use everyone, and it's definitely showing. I think at Miami they've always had athletes. I mean, they get them every year, but just figuring out what to do with them, you know, where to put them and how you want to scheme up your offense and defense. And they're doing a really good job. I think they're in a good spot. But like I said, I mean, they're fast. They got a lot of speed and they can really rely on that. But then also up front, I think they're physical and they're strong at the point of attack, and they're good. So, I mean, it's going to be a good challenge for us for sure.
Thanks.
Hey, Trevor, it's Pete at AP. Do you ever catch yourself thinking, hey man, I haven't thrown an interception in about a year almost? And what's that like when you're going through a stretch like this?
Honestly, I really didn't even, in my mind, I haven't really carried over, I guess, the streak from last year. I kind of new year started, I kind of forgot all about that. But I have, you know, I have thought this year, you know, I'm doing a good job taking care of the ball. That's been a priority for me. So, of course, I'm going to, you know, recognize when I'm doing it well. I think that's important as well as, you know, recognizing when you're not doing something well. So, for me, that's been a big emphasis this year. And I think I've done a good job of it so far. So, I think just keeping that sense of urgency and every week committing to that. And really that stems from being prepared, being focused, knowing the game plan, and trusting your guys to make plays, you know, instead of forcing things downfield, just take what they give you, let them work in space. And I think it's definitely working well for us right now.
Trevor, do you get picked sometimes at practice? And when you do your teammates kind of make a big show of it?
Yeah, definitely. I've thrown, I don't know how, I think I threw 4 or 5 in camp, kind of try to keep track of them. And I don't know how many in normal practices since the season started, but defense doesn't make too big a deal. Sometimes, I mean, we go back and forth in some practices in camp when we'd be in scrimmages and we would score, we'd celebrate, kind of get over there towards their sideline, and then they'd pick us off or get a turnover or stop, and they would celebrate too. So that's just fun, being competitive and just competing. That's what's fun about football. So they definitely give a little bit of that, but not too bad. We got a respect for one another that we know the next play is coming. So that's just,
is there one defender maybe who had a friend of yours who maybe had a little too much fun at your expense after getting one?
I think it was definitely more of a, I guess, event when they got an interception in the years past. I remember Tanner. I think we talked about it before. Tanner, he picked me off, I think, last fall camp. And running the other way, just throws the ball at me from, like, 30 yards away. So that's one example. But KJ, who was my old roommate, he still hadn't picked me off, but he dropped in coverage one day, and I threw it right at him. Hit him right in the hands, and I don't let him live that one down because he always wants to talk when he gets a sack in practice. So he always tells me to throw it to him, and I threw it right to him one day, and he didn't catch it. So I always make fun of him for that.
Trevor, since we're talking about interceptions, as a quarterback, how much can you appreciate the pick that Booth made in the end zone, the one-handed interception? And that seemed like a pretty cool moment for y'all as a team, going down and celebrating with him.
Yeah, it was awesome. So as a quarterback, I know that's got to be disappointing for the other guy that threw it when he makes a play like that. I know the feeling of you kind of throw a ball, try and give your guy a chance, and the defense just makes a great play. That doesn't feel good, obviously. But on the flip side, being one of our guys, I was just pumped. I mean, they were kind of on a drive right there. I just got a penalty, put them in the red zone or close to the red zone. And him to make that play and give us the ball on the 25 was huge in that game for sure. I mean, if they score right there, the game definitely is a lot tighter. So definitely helped us out a lot. And it's just fun. You know, I think the team we have is just got a lot of energy, a lot of young guys, but also good leaders. So we got a good mix of guys that are just, you know, full of life, can have fun. And you kind of saw that at the end, just celebrating, and we love it.
Hey, Trevor, you're talking about Miami defense earlier, and they have 4 interceptions this year. And what are they doing that forces those turnovers? And as you know, they take a lot of great pride in doing that with that turnover chain.
Yeah, I mean, I think it's as far as interceptions, it's just making every throw contested as a defense. That's really important. Not letting guys have a lot of separation. And if you can get your hands in there, you know, tips or picks, that's what our defense says all the time. So, that's one thing. And then also just they're athletes. You can't you really got to be on time with your throws. When the guy's open for a second, you better have already thrown it. You don't want to wait until that window closes. So that's one example. And then just as far as, you know, line of scrimmage, ball handling, all that stuff, they got a lot of speed. They're disruptive, and that can help definitely as far as that goes. So they do a good job. I think that's one thing they pride themselves on is getting turnovers, and they've done a really good job in the years past. You know, even if they didn't have as much success as a team, they've always done a good job getting turnovers. So that'll be a big challenge for us: is how can we limit that? How can we still win that margin, even though we're playing a team that's, you know, really good at that? So it'll be a good matchup for sure.
Hey, Trevor, it's David Hood again. I've seen you make a few throws to Amari this year when you release the ball, he's not necessarily even open, including that one kind of in the back of the end zone the other night where he made the great catch. I think that kind of shows the connection that you and Amari have, that you trust him. Can you just talk to us a minute about that connection and how much you do trust him? And is he kind of, you know, your go-to guy in certain spots that you'll make a throw even before he breaks open?
I mean, there's a lot of guys that I trust as receivers. I mean, we have a lot of talent, but also a lot of guys that have bought in and are really committed to this team and to playing their best. So, I trust a lot of those guys, but Amari, definitely, we've communicated a lot, and he's worked really hard to put himself in a position where he is now, playing really well. He looks fast, strong, all those things. And if Amari has half a step on someone, he's open, because his speed, once you throw the ball, he's going to accelerate even more. So I saw the guy covered him, had his back turned. So I just kind of run out of room in the back, so I just pulled him over a little bit. And the guy's head's turned in man coverage, so he's not going to be able to react to the ball. So just kind of pulled him towards the middle of the end zone a little bit more. Then Amari did a good job just separating. Like I said, I mean, when the ball's in the air, he just turns it on another gear. So he's really good at that, and just having that trust, like you said, having that trust in him. I have it in other guys too, but I think it's shown with Amari this early for sure.
Hey, Trevor, it's Trevor again. Joseph Ngata hasn't had any catches the last two games. You still managed to put up a lot of points, obviously, without him, but is this offense kind of incomplete without him, or I guess a better way to put that is, how much more dangerous will it be once, you know, he's in the full swing of things?
Yeah, I mean, it'll help us a lot. I mean, he's going into the year, he was our starting nine man, and definitely it's going to be huge to get him back. Just his size, he's really smart. He doesn't have any mental busts, really. I mean, it's rare that he does. Really smart, athletic, strong, big body. I mean, all those things, and he just knows what to do. So getting him back will be really big. But, we pride ourselves on having depth and having guys that can step up, and we've done that so far. But definitely, obviously, want him back. That's what we're trying to do. So hopefully we can get him back, kind of going full go. So that'll be really good for us. Give us just more options. I mean, it's nice having a lot of depth at receiver, and he's a playmaker. I mean, we've seen what he can do. So definitely excited to have him back.
Hey, Trevor, it's Zach Wagner with Clemson Sports News. What goes through your head when you hand the ball off to Travis or throw him the ball, and it seems like he's going to get tackled in the backfield? Next thing you know, he shakes off two tackles and he's 30 yards up the field.
Yeah, it's funny. So as a quarterback, obviously, after we hand the ball off, part of our offense is faking, you know, five hard steps, whichever way, opposite. So that's a big thing, is carrying out my fakes. We get graded on that for loafs if we don't do it. And, some games I'll get a couple loafs, and it's just hard to hand the ball to Travis and not to watch him run. So I have a hard time sometimes just handing it and looking the other way and carrying out my fake, because it's just the things he does. I mean, it's unbelievable sometimes. And he had that run down there, I think around the 10 or 12 yard line, we ran a counter and he just was tackled for a loss pretty much. So I'm like looking for the next play, and then boom, he busts out, ends up scoring. So just things like that. I mean, you never know what he's going to do, what kind of situation he's going to be able to get out of. So as, like I said, as a quarterback, it's sometimes you just want to hand it and just watch him run. I mean, see what he does, but it's a lot of fun. It definitely takes some pressure off me as a quarterback, you know, having that guy beside you.
We have time for one more question.
Coach Sweeney compared him to Walter Payton. I guess that's before your time, but does he remind you of anybody that you have seen over the years, just with his style and his power, just his blend of everything?
Yeah, I said earlier, I think as far as kind of the way he's trending in the passing game, it kind of reminds me a little bit of Alvin Kamara, just his ability to get upfield, to make people miss, but also just to break tackles. I think he's so hard to tackle. But as far as just in the box, running the ball, I honestly don't know. I would have to think about who he could compare to, but he's special, his speed. And if you hit him in the legs, I mean, not many people are going to take him down. So he's a special back for sure.